Now, adjust the volume control so that the sound can be heard in all parts of the room.
This is the Protect Your Assets podcast.
You get the idea? Bring me
a dream. It's on the internet.
Make him the cutest that I've ever seen.
Go on.
Give him two lips.
Like it's like no cheese I've ever tasted.
And tell him that his lonesome.
Here's the Sandman. Over
Sandman. Well, happy 2022. Can't even believe I'm saying that. It's 2022, and yes, it is a bright, crisp Bay Area morning. Did you have a good time last night? Well, I did. I stayed in, but the crab was really good. And as I was sitting there eating my crab, I started to write down some goals I had for 22. Did you? Was one of those goals retiring? Or is there something you really want to buy this year? Well, if that's you, then today you're in luck, because today's show is a financial boot camp.
Hoo-ah!
That's right. Today, I'm going to share with you some of the easy things you can do this year to start saving more money. So if your New Year's resolution was to do something financial, well, I'm here to tell you this morning, I will be your drill sergeant today. And I'm more than happy to help you get started on that right away. I know it's Saturday morning. I know it's cool. I know it's hard to get moving, but you can do this. For those of you just joining us for the first time, welcome. People around here, they call me the Sandman, and that's because I help my listeners sleep well at night by answering their most troubled legal or financial questions each week. So I was sitting there looking at the major stock markets, and we'll get to that in a minute, as through my famous market segment, as you know. We'll talk about the markets, how they did, what happened, what's going to happen next year, this year. We're already in it, 22. What should you expect? And since markets finished at all-time highs, the question I have for you is, are you prepared? Because this year, 2022, is going to bring some new volatility to the market. And if you're going to be taking care of yourself, say, for the next 20, 30, maybe even 40 years, if you're thinking about retiring, or maybe a mother-in-law, are you prepared for that? Well, there was a research report that came out recently which said that you're not. And I know for a lot of you, that's okay. Well, I'm just getting through each day, and I'm not really thinking about retirement. And the reason why this statistic or the survey talked more about that is because retiring today, they talked about, is so much different than it was even just 10 years ago. I mean, think about interest rates. Interest rates right now are at all-time lows. They're not likely to go that much higher anytime soon, because that'll destroy the market. You add on top of that, we are living a lot longer. We're so much more concerned now about what we're eating, how we're eating, when we're eating, physically fitness, how you're taking care of yourself. So you're living longer. And when you put those two things together, it becomes very difficult to have your assets generate income that you can live off of. And then you add to that market volatility, and it gets pretty tough. So who's going to help you figure this out? Well, this really is what got me thinking about this. It was a couple of weeks ago before we took the break. I was meeting with an engineer here from the Bay Area, worked for a very large, well-known company in the Bay Area. He'd been there for about 25 years. And he had saved a lot of money, a couple million dollars in stock, just stock benefits that he got from the company in his 401k. And he started telling me a story, because the company decided to go public, and then his stock became worth quite a bit of money. And so they invited several large brokerage firms to meet with these employees in a room, and they just said, here you go. Are you serious? Here you go? What does that mean? So he was telling me about how when he was sitting down with one of these advisors that they were just telling him about where to put his money, but there was no plan. There was no, when are you going to retire? What are you trying to do? It was one size fit all. Here you go. So that's too bad, because essentially the message is you're on your own. And I used to work for these companies, these large brokerage companies. And while they do tell you how to manage your money, just like everybody else, they don't do anything when it comes to planning, talking about taxes, how to build your foundation, and how to live off that for the next 20, 30, even 40 years. And that's dangerous. So if you're unsure about how you're going to retire, or maybe you just need a second opinion about your portfolio or what you should be doing right now, well, you've turned into the right place today, because we're going to get into it today. We're going to talk about some serious things that you can take some notes. And if you want to implement any of these, hopefully they will help you stick with your goal. So it's a brand new year. Take a big gulp of that ritual coffee. Get something to write with and get ready to become clear on fulfilling your New Year's resolution this January 1st, 2022. This is going to be a great show, so keep it right here. Now, let's get started. Well, markets for the year did pretty good. I always love looking in the rearview mirror. And I always do this on December 31st at the end of the market close. I come in and look at the market and see what happened. It's fun. I kind of enjoy it. That's kind of why I do this, I guess. Well, if you stayed invested, you know who I'm talking to out there. If you have stayed invested, you would have been pretty pleased with this. 2021 was the sixth best year for U.S. stocks since 1990. And this was the ninth year during that time frame with a return above 25% for the S&P 500. The S&P 500 also closed 70 days at record highs. Think about that. 70 days of record highs. And that was the second longest run, not to be beat by 1995, which went 77 days. So what are the statistics? Well, last week, for the week, the Dow was up 1.1, NASDAQ was up 0.9, the S&P was up 0.9%, I'm sorry, NASDAQ down 0.1%, so not much, and the 10-year Treasury around 1.51%, that's where we're starting the year off on the 10-year. Oil was about 2.3%. So for the year, what do you think? How do you think they did? Well, get ready to write these down, because this is important. The Dow Jones Industrial Average was up 18.7%. The S&P 500 was up 26.9%. The NASDAQ, your tech-heavy NASDAQ, was up 21.4%. So from a starting point, you can already see how large caps beat the NASDAQ. Which for all those of you running around, oh, my Apple, oh, my Microsoft, oh, my whatever, it's done so well. Well, yes, they have, but it teaches you about having all of your money in one stock. That can be very dangerous, and I'll get to that in a minute. Oil. Oil was the big one, folks. Oil was up 55.6% last year. Yeah. So what if you had no commodity exposure at all, and you missed that whole thing? That'd be terrible. So, as you can see, the best asset classes to be in last year, top two were U.S. large caps. Guess what? They were up 29%. And I can tell you in our portfolio, because that's what I look at, we had several positions that were very well diversified in core holdings that were up that 28, 29%. In one case, 38%. So, you know, I love having those conversations. Well, the S&P was up this, and I'm like, you don't have all your money in one index. Right? And why is that? Well, because when bad things happen, you don't want to lose a huge percentage of that. But did you have some of it? Yes, and you did pretty well. Good for you. Be pleased with that. Commodities. Other largest asset return. Just talked about that. What are the bottom? What are the worst? Who did badly? Poorly? Well, the bottom two asset classes were emerging markets, equities, down 3%. International bonds, down 7%. So think about that. Think about the fact that you could have a diversified portfolio. You could have some winners. And like you just saw, there's going to be some losers. And so your question immediately becomes, well, what's going to happen next year? And just to point out, I don't know if you've ever looked at the Russell 3000. That consists of the 3000 largest stocks that trade in the U.S. stock market. Guess what? It was down last year 3.44%. Yeah. So, you know, just think about what you're looking for and what you're doing. And if you don't understand this stuff, well, then think about this. What could go wrong for stocks right now? Because now we're sitting here in 2022. We've had a really good run. And now we're thinking about what could go wrong with our portfolios. How could we lose money? And then where do we want to be putting our money in 2022 now that there's been such a great run? And so the first thing we're going to talk about this morning is how you can position your portfolio right now, given some things that are becoming your way, and what to look for when we come back. That's what we're going to start talking about as a way to start to build your retirement plan. Because if you are that close to retirement or you're in retirement, the last thing you want to do is lose 20 or 30% of your portfolio as you walk into that retirement zone, particularly if you're relying on 100% of that portfolio to generate your income. So when we come back, we'll get into it. You're listening to the Protect Your Assets Show, because after all, that's what I'm here to do. I am your platoon sergeant this morning, David Hollander. We'll be right back.
If you missed any of Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, all you have to do is go to pyaradio.com, where you can download or listen to our latest shows for free. Just go to pyaradio.com on your computer or mobile device when it's most convenient for you. That's pyaradio.com. Now, back to Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, the Sandman. Out in Lukenbach,
Texas. Welcome back. You're listening to The Sandman, and this is the Protect Your Assets Show. Happy New Year to you, by the way. Happy 2022. And if you were thinking about making some changes to your financial life this year, then you've tuned into the right place, because this week and several weeks this month of January, we do our financial boot camp, where you can get yourself into financial shape by adopting some habits that we have found have worked for many, many folks for many, many years. So the first thing that we need to talk about this morning is your portfolio. We've had a good year. I went over the numbers during the market segment. By the way, if you have ever heard my podcast, I would encourage you to do that and share it with your friends, because we break it up into bite-sized chunks. So it's easy to digest, easy to listen to, whether you're cooking, driving to work, out for a walk. And you do that by going to Spotify and do a search, type in Protect Your Assets, and you'll see the podcast come popping up. And there you can listen to the market segment. It's real quick. It talks about what the markets did, what happened last week, what I think's going to happen the week coming up. So if you're getting ready for what's going to happen today, starting Monday, because the markets will be open again, it'll be a brand new year. And if you're at or near retirement or thinking about retiring or in retirement right now, the markets are at all-time highs. We had a really good run in 21, good run in 19, good run in 20. So the question is, are we going to be looking at 2018 again, where the S&P was flat to negative? Is that going to happen? And I was talking in the previous segment about having all your money into one position. If you had Alibaba, for instance, last year, guess what? You were down 47.2%. So that's why you don't have all your eggs in one basket. It's not a good idea, ever. Oh, yeah, you had Amazon, good for you, up 3.6. That's not so great, is it? No. Anyway, so these are the lessons you need to learn, okay? And that's why you have a professional help you with this. In any event, before we do that, I have a question that just came in from Sally in Mill Valley. I like that. Sally in Mill Valley. Okay, Sally, what's going on? She owns a condo in Corte Madera, in which her son Stanley lives in, rent-free. She applied for SSI income for him, and she was the representative and payee on the claim. The award was approved, but there is what's called an ISM deduction. And so Sally's asking me, can she charge her son rent to avoid the ISM deduction? Well, Sally answers, yes, you can do that. Oh, okay. She says, well, even if I am his representative payee, can I still do that? Yes, Sally, you can do that. But make sure it's fair market value, okay, Sally? Now, that's a question, because in Marin, what does it cost to rent a condo in Corte Madera right now? What's the fair market value of that? Well, that might be a problem. Follow me, Sally? So sounds like you need a lawyer, which, as you know, we are, and we're more than happy to help you do this. This is the sort of thing that you can get yourself in trouble into. So give us a call. We're happy to help you out. 866-PROTECT. All right, let's get back into the boot camp.
Hoo-ah!
Because I want to help you figure out with your portfolio, what should you be doing right now? What could go wrong here in 2022? After all, it seems like it's just been great. As I just said in the previous segment, we've had 70 days. 70 days of all-time high closings on the S&P 500. It's the second biggest ever. It's a record almost. So what could go wrong? Everything seems so great. Yep, Humpty Dumpty. All right, well, let's take a look at it. The first thing that could go right, but also could go wrong, these have both sides to it, would be inflation. And the next event that I'm going to be looking at is going to be in about 2 weeks, January 14th. That's where I get the CPI, Consumer Price Index number. And I expect inflation to be a major influence on markets this year in 2022. And that's because of the politics around inflation. You heard me. This is an election year. And now that the voters are concerned about inflation, as you should be, it's something that's going to be in Washington. And it's going to be discussed on Capitol Hill and the Fed. Don't kid you. The Fed is political. So this debate is something that's intense, and it's going to become more intense this year. And so this is what's behind the Fed's more aggressive tapering stance. We talked about this a lot towards the end of last year, which was how Chairman Powell all of a sudden did a reverse, started talking about becoming more hawkish, raising more times. In fact, talking about almost three times. That's my next one. That could be a problem. Is the Fed blowing it? Tightening too quickly, too fast, taking away too much money. And that goes hand in hand with inflation. Because as you know, as my daughter asked me this question, Dad, when there's inflation, how do you combat that? And I said, what do you think? She said, raise interest rates. I said, that's right. It's exactly how that works. The Fed's, one of their levers, they have many levers, but one of the levers they use to fight inflation is they raise rates, because that slows down the economy. But if they do it too quickly or incorrectly, that's what starts a recession. In other words, bad market returns. And that's why I was talking about 2018 could be repeated this year, 2022. Could be repeated in the sense that we have a flat to negative S&P 500, which means you better be looking at other things to invest in. So that's what could go right or wrong. Number two, which would be the Fed tightening too quickly. And so what you want to pay attention to there, let me give you my little cheat sheet here. It's the 10-year Treasury versus the 2-year Treasury, the spread between them. And if it's 1%, or greater, then that's okay. If it gets down closer to zero, then that's not okay. All right, so that's what you want to look for there. Now, the other thing that could be a problem could be corporate earnings. Now, the markets have absorbed the increase in prices. We know that. We've all been out there buying stuff, a lot of stuff, even though the prices are higher. And there's an argument that what's enabled that to happen has been all the stimulus, all the money floating around. And as I've been saying, that's going to stop. The Fed is going to stop printing money and they're going to start raising rates. And so will the consumer be able to pay the prices? That's arguable. And so if corporate profits aren't what they should be, and right now, just so you know, your portfolio right now is saying that in 2023, you heard me right, I'm already out to next year. That's how analysts look at stock values. They're saying that the price earnings on the S&P 500 right now is $250 a share. Yep. So if we don't hit the 250 number, then we've got a problem. Now we're going to start to see that here as fourth quarter numbers start to come out this first quarter coming up. So there's a lot of information that's going to start getting digested in the next couple of weeks, and that could affect your portfolio. And so all I'm saying right now is Monday might not be a bad idea to sit down, take a look at what you've done, where you've been, where you're trying to go, and to do something about it. The worst thing that could happen here is COVID. And again, as we've heard, this COVID variant is not as bad as the previous one in terms of the sickness level that people are experiencing, the hospitalization rates, the recovery, all that sort of thing. Okay. I'm not saying COVID is not bad. Of course it is. It's not, no one wants COVID. But the reality is people are getting better, and the market looks at that. The market says, well, this is not a game changer. It's not a lockdown scenario like we saw back in March of 20. And so the market should still maintain itself. But the problem is we're going to start to see a lot of numbers because this is so infectious. And right now, from the estimates that we're seeing, 700,000 people a day are going to be getting this starting this month. But again, we should get through it. Okay, that's my words of wisdom today. We're going to get through this year. I think this is going to be the end in a meaningful way of what we've experienced the last couple of years. Thank God, right? Thank you. So if you haven't gotten vaccinated yet, I guess I don't want to get on that tangent, but you know what? Come on. Anyway, so that's what's happening there. Now, the other thing that could happen, which you need to pay attention to, is, like I said, the government, because there's going to be an election in November. And if Republicans win either the House or the Senate, which is a possibility, folks, you saw what they did back in Virginia. This is something that's out there. And if that were to happen, guess what? The markets like that. The markets like gridlock. they don't like one party being in total control because it makes them nervous when it comes to tax policies or other regulations or laws. So if we get a roadblock, then the market will like that. And that'll be a positive for the market. So here we go. What are my golden wisdom numbers you've been sitting here waiting for? I know you. I see you. S&P 500, you ready? Well, if the things go right, like I just said, then you should be looking for 5,000 to 5,775 on the S&P 500. That's right. A midpoint number for you. 5450. That's if things go right. What if some things go wrong? What's the low point on this? Get ready. 4,068 on the S&P 500. Not too bad from where we are right now. I know you wouldn't like it, but sure, it's down to 3870. 3870 is my support there. Where should you be investing right now? Take a look at your portfolio right now. I encourage you to balance it out, maybe reset it. Put some more things with value and cyclicals. I keep saying that. Value and cyclicals look good in this environment. Stocks are going to beat bonds this year. It's just that simple. And if the emerging markets can get their act together, then I like what I see there. Now, here's what you can do right now. If you're trying to get prepared, if you're trying to say, look, My portfolio looks pretty good right now. I'm in pretty good shape. I feel pretty good after last night. You know what? I applaud you. I think that's awesome. But right now, let me be the wake-up call. You need to take some action. You have to do something about your future. Don't just let it ride because you're unique. You're different than your friend. And so if you want to retire this year, if you want to buy a second house, if you want to travel, and you want to do that for the next 10, 20, 30 years, how are you going to do that? How are you going to get the money every month consistently to make that happen from everything you've earned so far? It's a really good question. And we have the answer to you this morning. I have a free boot kit for you. This is the boot kit for the boot camp. You ready? And it's not going to cost you a nickel, but you have to do this. Here's how you get it right now. You call this number, 866-PROTECT. Call this number, 866-PROTECT, and talk to a member of my team. Or you can text this. Text PYA to 797979. I'm sorry. Text PYA to 797979 and get your boot camp kit. We'll email it over to you, and it'll help you get ready for whatever your challenges are you're thinking about this year to get financially fit. All right. Coming up next, I'm going to give you some basics. This is basic training, some basic ideas on what you can do to start to build your portfolio, build your financial future so you get ahead and not behind. You're listening to the Protect Your Assets Show with David Hollander. I am the Sandman, and I'll be right back.
If you missed any of Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, all you have to do is go to pyaradio.com where you can download or listen to our latest shows for free. Just go to pyaradio.com on your computer or mobile device when it's most convenient for you. That's pyaradio.com. Now, back to Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, the Sandman.
Welcome back. I'm David Hollander, also known as the Sandman, and you're listening to Protect Your Assets. This happy new year, happy 22 to all of you out there. And if you're ready to make some big financial changes here in 2022 to your life, then good for you, because January is typically the time people make and then try to keep their New Year's resolutions. And so last night, if you were thinking about how you'd like to change your financial world for the positive this year, then I applaud you. Because that's the first part of any sort of change, is you have to think about it. And then you have to believe it. And then you have to execute on it and follow up on it to make sure you get it done. And those are really some of the big secrets that I've found that many, many of my clients have done well and have done well. So, what does that mean? And how do you do some things that the smart people do to keep more money and make more money and grow their fortunes to become very wealthy people? These are some secrets that I've uncovered from working with many, many successful entrepreneurs over the years. And what I will say is that boot camp today can really help you do some things like save more money, pay less taxes, and create income that you can never outlive. Think about that. So now it's time for one of our fan favorite parts of the show, our They Say segment, where we debunk common myths, half-truths, and sometimes just bad advice that they say.
Who are they? What do they know that I don't? And what are they saying this week? There's only one man with all the answers. And here he is, David Hollander, the Sandman.
So here's one they say that can really get you in trouble. They say that you need a certain number in your 401k account to retire. Is that always true? Well, the answer is no, it's not. And I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but don't think about it, about a certain sum of money. I know a lot of people tend to get in this dangerous mode, which is, you know what, I need to have $1 million or $2 million to retire. And I always ask them, why? Why is that? Well, I just heard that, or they said that. That's just wrong. What's more important is to think about what is it that you want to do in your retirement. What are you trying to accomplish? And then we have to look at some things like taxes, like your Social Security, like your family history, like at your health. This is all important because I'll tell you one secret that I've learned from many, many, many people, and I've talked to thousands of people over my 30 years of doing this, is that even though you may have a lot of money, guess what? Your spending ratio is about the same as someone who doesn't have a lot of money every month because you find ways to spend your money. It just goes. It just gets spent on stuff, and we never seem to feel like we have enough. It's human nature. So that's why I'm going to have you think about this a little differently this morning. Don't think about, well, I wish I had this much money. No. What you need to do first is you have to think about what it is you want to do. It sounds simple, but it's actually what it is. What do you want to do? Well, I want to retire in September of 22. Okay, that's a great idea. Now, what are you going to do in retirement? Try and visualize that. Are you going to take a new job? Are you going to volunteer? Are you going to start another company? Are you going to spend more time with your family? You know, take up a new sport? These are all great ideas. And so please let your mind go and think about that and write it down. That's why I had you get a pencil and paper this morning. I still like my pencils. Anyways, write down right now. Write down a couple ideas. What comes to your mind? Okay, so now that you've written that down and you see, I want to do this or that, I want to help you get there. And so the way you do that is you start to develop a plan. It's a map. It's your roadmap. It's how we're going to build your house. So when you walk out of work, you can walk into this new house and it's going to take care of you. And if you don't have the blueprints built, guess what? Your house isn't going to look really good. And when bad things happen, like we have a big storm coming, it's going to blow that house down. And you're going to be sitting there going, now what? So that's what happened with John and Nancy. I'll tell you a story about John and Nancy. John and Nancy came to us several months ago. They wanted to retire. They wanted to travel, particularly after the lockdown. They really wanted to get out there and start seeing the world. Their house was paid off. They have two adult children who are out there self-sufficient, which is great. They're excited about that. They had about $4 million in savings and retirement and 401ks, which sounds like a lot of money. But this is the question they had, which was a really good question. They said, you know what? We've talked to a lot of different financial advisors, and they all say, we're fine. We're not going to run out of money during our lifetime. But that's not the question. The question we have for you, Mr. Sandman, is how much money can we spend every month, starting in September, till the last of us dies and leave our kids, say, a house and maybe $500,000 of our portfolio? How much can we spend every month? Well, if you think about that question, you think about how tough that question is. Because let's say they're in their early 60s, and statistically, one of them is going to live to be 95. That's the statistic today. Good morning. So if one of them is going to live another 30-something years, what's the answer to that? And I encourage you right now, if that's what you're thinking about, like how much can I spend and have $2 in the bank when I die, right? Because I don't have anybody to leave it to. I don't have two kids. Great. Can you answer that question for yourself? No? Okay, I don't expect you to. You're not a professional in this area. Well, go to your professional and ask your professional that question and see if they can answer it. Because chances are, I don't think they can. And I think when the bad markets start to happen, you're going to start to question them because you're going to see what's happening to your cash flow. Okay, I've seen it many times. So if you're wondering, how do you do this for yourself? How do you get ready like John and Nancy, to answer that question of how much can you spend each month and not run out of money and live a great life and really enjoy it. Well, then you have to pick up the phone right now. You have to pick up the phone and you have to call me, 866-PROTECT, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to email you our Get Started Kit to help you answer that question. And it's absolutely complimentary because it's my New Year's present to you. Happy New Year. 866-PROTECT, because this could change the next 30 years of your life. Think about that. If you'd like to get it another way, you can text PYA, text PYA for Protect Your Assets on your phone. Text PYA to 797979. Again, text PYA to 797979, and we'll send you my Bootcamp survival kit, which will help you get started on your mission this morning. Now, when I come back, your property taxes just went up. You heard me. Find out how much and what you can do about it to lower it. You're listening to the Protect Your Assets Show on the Protect Your Assets Radio Network. We'll be right back.
If you missed any of Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, all you have to do is go to pyaradio.com where you can download or listen to our latest shows for free. Just go to pyaradio.com on your computer or mobile device when it's most convenient for you. That's pyaradio.com. Now, back to Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, the Sandman.
Welcome back. I'm David Hollander, also known as the Sandman. And you're listening to Protect Your Assets this morning, and a happy 2022 to you. And I want to welcome all of our new listeners in the Orange County area. January is typically the time that people make and try to keep New Year's resolutions. And if you found yourself doing that last night, trying to get your financial house in order this year, this was the year you're going to do it. You're going to make some changes. Well, good. And I hope this morning helped you get started. Whether it's buying a new home, saving more for retirement, or even retiring this year, today's show has been dedicated to you. And this entire month, each Saturday, we're going to be doing a financial boot camp where you're going to get some ideas about how to get your financial act in order.
Hoo-ah!
Now, I want to wish some happy birthdays to Tim DeRuiter, Coach DeRuiter, Bob Davis, Sandy Dole, Bev Morgan, Cindy Myers. Hope you guys have a great birthday week. So, did you hear about this? Your property taxes just went up on any real estate that you might own in California. What am I talking about? Write this down. Again, this is why you have the pencil this morning. Write this down. www.boe.ca.gov/prop19. Now, this is the California Board of Equalization's site, and I want you to read through this because you're going to see some things there that may cause you some concern. Let's say that you bought a property back in 1986 in San Anselmo, and you paid $210,000 for it, and your county taxes right now are based on that purchase price plus Prop 13. So currently you find yourself paying about $5,000 a year in property taxes for that property, which is very affordable for you and feels great and you're fine. But in your trust, it says that your children will receive that house when you die. And one of the children would like to stay in the house. Or if you have rental property, maybe they want to keep renting those properties out to tenants and get income from that and keep that in your family. Well, let's say that that house or that rental property is now worth $3.2 million in today's market, which is a difference of almost $3 million. And so this new tax law that I just told you about says that when you die, your child will end up paying roughly $30,000 a year. You heard me right. Went from $5,000 up to $30,000 a year in annual taxes to the county just for the privilege of holding onto that piece of property. Yeah. So your question is, well, will my trust that I've done, my revocable living trust, is that going to protect us from this new tax? No. How many times can we do this? Three. It's three transfer limits. You say this sounds unfair. This is alien. This is not okay. But guess what? The counties need your money in California right now. And they're coming after your most valuable asset. So the key to protecting your most valuable assets is to call us right now. Call this number, 866-PROTECT, because you want to protect what you've worked so hard for. Call 866-PROTECT right now. Talk to a member of my team and find out about this new law and how to protect yourself before it's too late. 866-PROTECT, because that's what we do. We help protect our clients' assets. I'd like to give a big thanks this morning to the Protect Your Assets team for putting together another great show this morning. Executive producer and network manager Kevin Renfer. And of course, all my fabulous producers back there helping out. Walter, Phil, thank you so much this morning, because without my team, I'm just another pretty voice on the radio. You've been listening to the Protect Your Assets show with David Hollander. I am the Sandman. Go out and make the rest of your life the best of your life.
The information given on this program is in the nature of general financial comment for informational purposes only and does not purport to be a complete statement of all material facts related to any topic, company, industry, or security mentioned. The opinions and views expressed in any strategies mentioned or guidance provided reflect our judgment now, are subject to change without notice, and may or may not be updated. Past performance should not be taken as an indication of future performance, and no representation, guarantee, or warranty, express or implied, is made regarding performance. The information provided herein is not suitable for everyone and may not be appropriate for all investors. It is not based on any individual's needs, does not intend to provide individualized investment advice, and cannot be relied upon as to your specific financial situation, a basis for your investment decisions, recommendations, or for any other type of investment or course of action. Proper advice depends on a complete analysis of all the facts and circumstances and a consideration of your specific situation and objectives. To better understand the risk associated with investing and how it reacts to different market conditions, listeners should always consult with their qualified investment professionals, financial advisors, legal or tax specialists, and conduct their own due diligence prior to making any financial decisions or taking any action. The legal information provided on the air is not intended to substitute for callers hiring their lawyers to advise them about personal legal matters. Investment involves risk and, unless otherwise stated, are not guaranteed. Past performance is no guarantee of future results, and any expected returns or hypothetical projections presented herein may not reflect actual future performance. All calls will be screened, and callers should not expect the conversation with David Hollander on the radio or with staff to be held in confidence. Liberty Group, LLC, paid for the following program, and the host's views and opinions do not represent those of the station or its ownership. California Life Agent number 048569. KNBR and Liberty are not affiliated. You're listening to the Protect Your Assets Radio Network.